Welcome back, LegendaryPotato here, and today I'm going to be going through the top 5 glitches I found that are still working in TU60. So these are all really cool glitches. They're not really anything like duplication glitches, but they're glitches that I think are really fascinating and worth checking out in the game. So if you guys will enjoy the video, of course, if you do, make sure you do leave a like on it. It does help out the channel, but let's get into this video. So pretty much we got 5 glitches here, so let's go through them. And so the first one here is going to be the floating sand, which you've probably seen this one before, but this one's a really cool one to see. And so if we just drop a bunch of sand in here onto this fence post, which is the reason this glitch works, as you can see, the sand is going to jiggle a little bit, and that's because the sand is still falling. But basically what ends up happening is that because it's still falling, and there's no more that can like fall down, and so it creates this sand that actually floats forever, at least until you decide to disable this. So if I want to go ahead and start piling up the sand, and let's say we want to go this way, as you can see, the sand is not going to fall. So I can just kind of walk around and do this for as long as I'd like. But as you can see, nothing exactly happens. But if I were to go ahead and break this fence post like this, as you can see, the sand starts falling. So you can pretty much disable gravity and kind of turn it on and off as much as you'd like, which I think is a really cool glitch, of course. So as you can see, all this sand that was floating up at top is now here. So that's a really cool glitch, of course. I think it's a fun one to take advantage of and just kind of play around with it. It works with anvils and stuff too, so you can choose a lot of things that normally fall and they can actually, you know, stay floating. But let's continue on to the next glitch here, which is going to be the nether portal. And so this might take a few tries for me to get, but we're going to see if we can try and get it here. And so I believe you can do this in survival. I'm not too sure. I'm going to do it in creative mode here because it's a little bit easier to demonstrate. But let's see if we can get it first try. Ooh, we might have actually gotten it first try if we did that. That's pretty good. Did we get it? Oh, we did. Okay, awesome. So as you can see here, you can break off parts of the nether portal while still having all intact. So as you can see, I can get rid of the corners. That's not going to do anything. But as you can see here, we have a missing block just sitting right there. Let's try and get another block. So we'll just go in like this, and you want to break it at the same time. I missed it there. You want to break it at the same time as you enter, and so it won't update the nether portal, and it won't break it. And so, did we get it? I don't think we got it that time. We probably... Oh, okay, we did get it. So, as you can see here, really cool glitch, and it allows you to break this nether portal. So, one by one, you can break off each thing, and you just have this floating nether portal thing here, and it still fully works, and everything like that. So, as you can see, this wall has just completely come off. Really, really cool trick. So, I'll do it one more time just to demonstrate, which I think we got it there. Let's go ahead and check. And no, we didn't get it, but that's okay. You guys get the idea, of course. It makes this weird lighting glitch too when you do it, which is kind of fascinating. But yeah, so that's the glitch here. I'm not sure if you can place blocks next to it. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. So just keep in mind if you do that. Ooh, it turns back into obsidian. That's kind of cool. So yeah, just something to keep in mind. If you want to have a weird looking nether portal, that might be the way to do it right there. I'll do it one more time just to demonstrate, of course. There we go. I think I got it. Did I get it? Yes, I did. So you can do that in your worlds. I do think that if you do this though, that once you reload the world, it'll go back to normal. But if you want to confuse your friends, then this is something you can probably do, and I think that's really interesting, of course. But let's move on to the next glitch, which of course is going to be the top of the nether. So let's go to the nether here, which this is a really old glitch, but it's also had some changes to it, which not everyone quite knows about. At least I don't really go to the top in the nether. I haven't really ever done that before. But let's go to the top. So I need to ender pearl through here like this, and let's try and get out like this. So we'll just try and get up. So you have to ender pearl like this. And as you can see, so now I'm at the top, and it's going to be very hard for me to get out, of course, because I'm stuck up here because you can't move around. But you can get to the top of the nether, and so it's basically just this open bedrock area, and you can't really do much inside of it. But we can try and get out of here if we can. Let's see if we can. I don't know. It's probably going to be a little difficult to do this, but as you can see, it's a pretty cool trick. You can get up to the top of the nether, and after that, you're kind of stuck. So let me see how I can get out of here. I'm probably going to be stuck for a little bit. All right, there we go. I found out how to die in the nether. You can place down some lava, but you're not going to be able to place blocks or break them. It's kind of weird. So let's go back and let's get started with that again. Okay, so now that we're back, of course, so there you go, there's the nether portal. So you can get out of the nether. You can't do anything in there, but I think it's quite interesting that you can do that nonetheless. So let's move on to the next one here, which is right down here. We'll go ahead and get some buckets, or we'll just get one bucket for this. And we'll also go into survival mode, since that's the only way this trick works. It can work in adventure mode too, I guess. But basically what we want to do is we want to go to the edge of a world. So just to prove, of course, this is the edge of the world. I'll just kind of show you guys, of course. Well, you can see that I can walk over there anyway. But you want to go to a corner or an edge of a world like I am here. And so once you've done that, on a 360 world, it's pretty easy. On an Xbox One world, it might be a little bit more difficult. And so you're going to want to grab some water for the edge of the world. And so what this will do is it will create this really weird water effect. So it's kind of like placing down water, but you'll see exactly what happens here. So we place it down, and it creates this still water. So instead of it flowing like it normally does, so let's show you guys normal water, of course. If we do this, normally what happens is it kind of flows around like that. But once we get the water from the edge of the world, what ends up happening is, I can't seem to place the water down. There we go. What happens is that it doesn't actually flow, so it kind of stays like this. I don't know if it stays like that. Pretty much when you place it down, if you reload the world, I would imagine it will probably update it and make it normal water. But this is a cool glitch, of course, if you want to confuse your friends, of course, which you probably do, as you can see here, just kind of like the still water here, which is pretty neat. So that's kind of an easy way to place down some still water, see exactly what happens, but pretty cool nonetheless is that you can actually get this weird water effect in your world. And so if I wanted to place it above a lever, like, whoa, this is kind of confusing, right? I could do that, or like up here. It's just, you could put it anywhere, and I think it's kind of cool. And I guess you could use it for like trying to pile up and stuff. If you wanted to like swim up somewhere, you can do like this, and then like suddenly up here and there's no mess. It's pretty good. It's a pretty good trick, of course. So do whatever you'd like with that. I think that's a cool one to show off. Not many people actually know about that one. So let's move on to the last one over here, which is going to be an x-ray glitch. So let's come all the way down to the bottom of the world. Oh, I'm in survival. So let's go ahead and go back over to our little thing. That actually just kind of scared me a little bit. I forgot I was in survival. So you can do this one in survival, or you can do it in creative. It's easier to do in creative mode, but it's still possible to do in survival mode. So you want to go to the bottom of the world without dying, preferably. And so as you can see here, we got some beds set up with some blocks above them. So if we go ahead and sleep in these beds, which we need to set it to night, and then we sleep in the bed, as you can see, we can see through the world. And so we can see cave systems, we can see, like, sometimes you can see diamonds and stuff. Oh, I got stuck. Where am I? I don't know where I am. Let's get some night vision. I don't know where I am. Okay, I'm inside this block. So you gotta be a little bit careful, is that sometimes you'll get stuck in the block, and it's just not that great. So you want to be careful. But you can see, like, with the night vision, oh, we can see a dungeon over there. You can see over on the left side, you can see a dungeon. This is a really great way to locate structures like dungeons or mine shafts or anything like that. Like, there's that dungeon over there. Pretty cool stuff. And so we can also do this from any direction as well. So if you want to go ahead and turn this way, let's see if you can find anything cool over here. Just some cave systems. I saw some gold over there. Let's keep looking, of course. But if you're doing this in survival or without host privileges, then you got to keep in mind as well is that you got to get out of bed before it turns day. Otherwise, you can't do it anymore until the night. So I think that's something to keep in mind, of course, is that it's a little bit important. But for me, since I have host privileges, I can just set it to be always day. So I don't have to worry about that anyways. But yeah, it doesn't look like we found anything interesting, but there's random little water and lava pockets, which is kind of weird. I don't know why those are there. I guess that's a new random thing to see. But yeah, as you can see, just in general, pretty cool stuff, so you can see through the world. So if we wanted to find a dungeon, for example, then right there, that helped us make it much easier to find one. Since sometimes they can be a little bit difficult to find, and you want to find a mob spawner, then that's something you can do, of course, which is quite helpful. So of course, you can do this anywhere in the world. So if we want to go somewhere else, let's say we want to go over to, where are the beds anyway? They're in the miscellaneous. So let's say we just want to go anywhere. Like, you can do this around your world. It's really easy to set up. So let's say we go over to here. So let's just give ourselves, we only gave ourselves 45 seconds of night vision. It's kind of a little annoying, of course. But if we just go anywhere in the world, we can find more stuff. And so you can just kind of travel the world really easily and just kind of do this trick. And we can just set it up super quickly here, put in some blocks. It doesn't even have to be block iron. It could be anything. I just have that in my inventory, of course. But yeah, as you can see, a lot going on. It looks like we're not spawning in the wall this time, which is great. So it makes it much easier to do this. But it doesn't seem like it's found any structures, but there's so many cave systems over here, which is quite helpful. So you'll probably be able to find a lot of cool stuff. Actually, there might be a dungeon. I can see some lava flowing over there. That was kind of cool. But other than that, it doesn't seem like I see anything. Maybe you guys might be able to see something, but personally, I do not. So if you guys do, let me know down in the comment section, but I'll look one more time, of course, so let's just do that. There we go, night vision. I'll just look, just get one more glance at it, but it doesn't seem like we found anything here, unfortunately. But that's pretty much the glitches I have for you guys in today's video. I thought they're all really cool glitches. They're nothing like duplication glitches, which, you know, obviously there's always been those that showed off. If you want to see duplication glitches, of course, I have a bunch of videos on duplication glitches. I recommend you guys check those out, of course, which, of course, I'll put some cards on the screen as well if you guys want to see those. But I'll see you guys in the next video. Make sure you do leave a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you guys want to see more videos like these. But I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good one, guys, and peace out.